Hello. In this video, I will be explaining the basics of signals and slots using the Qt framework. Before watching this video, ensure you are familiar with the basic concepts of C++ and object-oriented programming. I will demonstrate the concept of signals and slots by creating a basic console application in Qt Creator. But before doing that, we will look at an image which I believe visually explains how signals and slots function. At a high level, signals and slots are a method of communication between objects. A signal is meant to represent some action occurring. A slot is meant to represent some functionality which should happen because of that action. The signal is then connected to the slot, so that the slot will be executed whenever the signal is emitted. For example, let us say we have a save button to save a document we are creating in a text editor. The act of clicking the save button would be the action and should therefore emit the clicked signal. The signal would then be connected to a slot, which would execute the function that saves the document. If we look at the image, you can see the representation of this concept visually. Looking at the image on the right, you can see we have four objects which contain either signals, slots, or both. The arrows in this image represent the connections between signals and slots. You can also see that we are not restricted to creating a single connection, but instead, a single signal can be connected to multiple slots, and a single slot can be connected to multiple signals. Now that we have a visual understanding of signals and slots, I will move over to Qt Creator to see how this can be done in a simple program. Here I have created an empty console application called Signals and Slots. The first thing we need to do is create a few new classes, so I will create one called Sender and another called Receiver, both of which will inherit from Qt Object. I then need to add the header and implementation files for each of these classes to add executable in the cmakelist.txt file. With this done, we can start to flesh out our classes. First, I will go to my sender.h file. We can see by default that there is already a place for us to define our signals, so underneath signals, I will add the following code. Unlike a typical function, signals should not be implemented, so we do not need to add anything to our implementation file. So, I will now move over to my receiver.h file. First, I will include qdebug, which is a library used for logging and which we will be using in the implementation. Then, I will need to create a place for my slots to be defined, so I will add the following. Then directly underneath this, I will add my slot. We will then move over to our implementation file to implement this slot, so we will refactor our slot. Here, I will add something simple to this slot, just to show that we are executing the slot. Although what I am adding here is simple, you could add functionality you would like here to be executed anytime the signal is emitted. With that added, we are ready to connect our signals and slots, which, in this example, will be done in our main. So, I will move over to my main CPP. First, we will need to make sure we are including both of our classes, so I will add the following. Now we will create an instance of both of our classes, so I will add the following code. Now that we have both of our objects created, we are ready to connect our signal to our slot. To do this, we are going to use the connect function, which is a part of QObject. So we will add the following. The parameter that needs to be added to this can be a bit tricky, so I will copy in some instructions. Now, do note the connect function is overloaded a number of times, so looking through the documentation, you will see there are a number of ways to do it, but I will show you my preferred way. Here are some instructions on how to make our connection. First, we need a pointer to the signaling object. Second, we need a reference to the signal that we are connecting. Third, we need a pointer to the receiving object. And finally, we need a reference to the slot we are connecting. With that done, our signal and slot are connected. This connection will remain as long as both objects exist, meaning these objects can communicate through this connection even when they don't know about each other. Finally, all we need to do is emit our signal and our program is complete, so I will add the following code. And we are now ready to run our application, so I'll click Run. And here you can see that our slot is being executed right after our signal is emitted. Although this program is simple, this is how all components within the Qt framework will communicate, so it is fundamental to have a strong understanding of how this works. So, I strongly advise making sure this is clear before moving on to more complex topics. If you ran into any problems throughout this tutorial, please feel free to create a support ticket through your Qt account, and we will be sure to help resolve your issue. Thank you.